This is Catherine Schmer at Chattanooga State Community College. This is video one on the topic of vectors. And in this video, we will talk about basic properties of vectors. A vector is a quantity that has both magnitude and direction. It's often represented by an arrow. Some examples of vector quantities include velocity, acceleration, force, and weight. Notice that all of these have not only a length or speed, but they also have a direction in which they're headed. Examples of scalar quantities, which don't necessarily have a direction, include speed, temperature, and mass. So hopefully that helps you distinguish between what would constitute a vector, what would be a scalar. Two vectors are equivalent or equal if they have the same length and direction. So here in this figure, we have four different vectors that have the same length and direction, but they're at different points in space. But we would consider each of these vectors equal because they have the same length and direction. To add vectors, you line them up head to tail. So let's say I have a vector u and another vector v. And I want to add them together. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to place vector v at the end of vector u, and the resulting vector, so starting from the initial point of u, going to the terminal point of v, is going to be vector u plus v. Let's try it the other way, where we put vector u at the end of vector v and see what happens. So I place vector u at the end of vector v, and my vector v plus u will have initial point at the initial point of v and terminal point at the terminal point of vector u. Notice that u plus v is equal to v plus u. So vectors have the property that if you add them together, it's commutative, meaning that you can switch the order. You can multiply vectors by real numbers or scalars, and this affects the length and or direction of the vector. So I'm going to start with vector u, and let's say I multiply that by 2. What that is going to do, it's going to stretch it out so that it's twice as long, but it will have the same direction as vector u. So I end up with vector 2u, and it has the same initial point as u, but the length is twice as long. Now I have another vector. I'm going to use vector u again. Let's say I multiply it by negative 2/3 u. The negative is actually going to make it go in the opposite direction, and the negative 2/3 will make it have a length that's 2/3 as much as vector u. So I end up with a vector that has the same initial point as vector u, but it's going in the exact opposite direction with 2/3 the length. We can write vectors in component form, which would be for two dimensions in R2. We have vector v equals, and it's an angle bracket, v1 comma v2. So this is actually equivalent to an x and a y. So you could also write it as an angle bracket with x comma y inside of the bracket. Now in R3, or three dimensions, we could have x comma y comma z all inside the angle bracket. So a more general way of writing this is vector v, so it has the arrow over the top to show that it's a vector. Vector v equals angle bracket v1, v2, v3. So that's one way to represent vectors is in this component form with the angle brackets. The standard position vector representation of vector V, and we're working in R3, so it's V1, V2, V3 are the components of vector V, is the vector with initial point at the origin, 0, 0, 0, and terminal point at the point, V1, V2, V3. So again, that's the standard position vector, has initial point at the origin. So in this figure, I have vector PQ going from point X1, Y1, Z1 to point X2, Y2, Z2. And what I would do to put it in standard position is I would just take that vector and move it so that its initial point is at 0, 0, 0. And then I could represent the vector as vector V equals V1, V2, V3. Now in another video, we'll talk about how to get those components, V1, V2, V3, from our P and Q points. To add vectors in component form, we add the corresponding components, meaning you'd add the X components together and you'd add the Y components together separately. So in example one, we want to calculate 3 times the vector 4, 1 minus 2 times the vector 0, 7. So these are vectors in R2, or two dimensions. And the first thing I want to do is distribute the 3 to the 4 and the 1, and distribute the 2 to the 0 and the 7. So that gives me vector 12, 3. So I did 3 times 4 to get the 12, 3 times 1 to get the 3. Minus vector 0, 14. So I distributed the 2 to multiply by the 0 and then by the 7. Now I'm going to, since it's a subtraction in this case, I'm going to subtract corresponding components. So I'll get 12 minus 0 will give me my X component, and 3 minus 14 will give me my Y component. And so the resulting vector is vector 12, negative 11. And we're putting it in component form, so that means in the angle brackets.